What's up everybody, welcome back to another video from exotic astrology. God is there with you all the time, just look to him and he will be there right with you. Yes, so today we will continue with another video from the dignity of planets. We discussed about the exaltation, the own sign, the mool trikon and the debilitation, and if you have not watched them, please go and watch. Otherwise, you will not understand this video, okay? You might understand, but you will get a better understanding if you watch them. And also, please subscribe to my channel if you have still not. And if you have any questions, queries and comments, then please let me know in the comment section, okay? So, today, what's the topic? Today's topic is discussing about the friend signs of the planets. So before discussing about friend signs, it is important for us to know who are friends in astrology, okay? Who are considered to be friends as per Vedic astrology, which planets are considered to be enemies, okay? And it is generally seen that planets do reasonably well in their friend signs, okay? I will give you the ultimate analysis later in the last video of enemy signs, of how every planet does in all of the other zodiac signs, and then we will also see the different degrees of exaltation, debilitation, where is it considered to be mool trikon, etc. Okay, so let's start with the first group. Always remember, in astrology there are two groups, okay? First group is the group of the Suras, okay? Suras are the demigods who abide by the laws of God, who help us to go close towards the Almighty. Yes, those are the Suras, those who benefit the world, okay, who benefit the soul actually, okay. And the Asuras are the group of planets who are against this purpose of the Suras, okay, who make us suffer, okay, who gives us suffering, okay. Now if I tell you the groups of the planets, you might be surprised that how is this planet Sura and how is that planet Asura, okay. Asuras are the group of people who do not abide by the laws of God, okay, who only think about themselves, who does not think about others, okay, and who create trouble for others, okay. And we will see how these come in the picture. For example, the Suras in the planet, in the group of planets, the Suras are the Sun, Moon, Mars and Jupiter, okay, and these four are best friends, okay. So, and on the other side, the Asuras are Jupiter, Mercury, Venus and Saturn, okay, and Rahu also. And Ketu is considered to be a fiery planet, so there is not much clear distinction, but it is a planet of outer worldly things, spirituality, so we cannot put it into either this or that, okay. Now the Sun, Moon, Mars and Jupiter are considered to be Suras, okay, and that is why they are best friends, okay. Because Sun and Moon represents the self, Jupiter represents connection to God, higher wisdom, and Mars represents the energy which we use to do these things, okay. And Mercury, Venus represents what? They represent the materialistic things of life, okay. Venus represents women, money, sexuality, luxuries, cars, home, etc., okay. And Mercury primarily represents money, okay. And these are the things, and Saturn represents sorrows, delays, disappointments, struggles, hardships, etc., okay. Saturn is basically the pain of a person who has been defeated, okay, apart from the other things. And Mars is the happiness which you get when you defeat somebody, yes. So these are the planetary groups. There are two groups, I will just repeat, the Suras of Sun, Moon, Mars and Jupiter, okay. And whenever these planets are placed together in a chart or they are aspecting each other, they always help each other, okay. We will discuss what aspects are later, but as of now, or when they are sitting in each other's signs, they will also benefit each other, except apart from exceptions of Mars being in Cancer, where it gets debilitated, and Moon being in Scorpio, where it gets debilitated. Other than that, Moon does good in the signs of Jupiter or in the signs of sign, okay, or in the signs of the Sun, which is Leo, and in its own sign also, Cancer. And apart from that, Mars also does good in the signs ruled by Sun and Jupiter, okay. Not very good in the sign which is ruled by Moon, because it gets debilitated there, okay. And on the other hand, on the group of the Asuras, who are known as the demons, okay, they represent the mundane world, the materialistic world, okay. They are Mercury, Venus and Saturn, because in this mundane world there is happiness and there is misery simultaneously. Venus is happiness, pleasure basically. Happiness is more of Jupiter, contentment. Venus is pleasure, the mundane pleasure which you get from substances of this world. And Saturn represents sorrow. So in this world, happiness and unhappiness, disappointment, go together always. They are like the railway track, which are always together, right? Now, Venus does relatively good in the sign of Gemini, because it is its friendly sign, Mercury sign, and it gets debilitated in the sign of Virgo. Okay, so just because a sign is a friend sign, it does not mean that it will always do good. For example, Mars and Moon, when they sit in each other's sign, okay, they get debilitated. So similarly, when Venus sits in the sign of Virgo, which is the sign of Mercury, it gets debilitated. And why does it get debilitated? That I have already explained in the video of debilitation. Please go and watch it. And similarly, Saturn, on the other hand, gets exalted in Libra, which is the sign of Venus, which is its friend, right? So, because Libra sign helps the agenda of Saturn to balance everything in life, balance our duties, actions, our responsibilities, to give the things their right due. So these are the ways by which we can know the performance of planets in their respective friends. Okay, for example, if you take Sun, quickly I will go over. Sun is excellent in Leo, and in the sign of its friend Aries, it gets exalted, right? We have explained why Sun gets exalted there. So please go and see the video of exaltations to understand that. Then you take Sagittarius. Sun is very powerful in Sagittarius. The person becomes very committed towards his duty, what he thinks is right, to do the right thing, to follow God, to follow spirituality, and to bring out change in the society. Okay. Sagittarius is the divine sign, which is the sign of inspiration, hope, and gratefulness, gratitude, serving the Guru, serving God, etc. Okay, that's a very powerful sign for the Sun. I consider Sun to be, in my experience, I have seen that Sun is better. It is better to have Sun in Sagittarius than either in Leo or in Aries also. Because if the Sun is in Leo or in Aries, he may even be a terrorist, or he may be a saint, he may be anybody, but he will be very fixed with his purpose. But if his Sun is in Sagittarius, then he will be fixed also, and at the same time he will look to go towards God also, which is very much important, right? Otherwise, what will you do by having an exalted Sun if you are just a mundane person with no goals and spirituality? It can help you, there's no doubt about it. You'll be very strong, very firm, very bold, and very courageous, very confident. But then, is it ultimately leading you to something good? That is also something which has to be checked, yes. And Sun exalted can also make a person very great leader in spiritual circles, okay. At the same time, Sagittarius is very good for spirituality. So, Sun does excellent there. And Sun also does good in the sign of Scorpio, okay. Because it enlightens the zone which is very dark, okay. Sun in Scorpio people, they can take lessons from ups and downs of their life, okay. They can understand things and they can cope up with the shortcomings which they have if Sun is in Scorpio, because Sun is always showing them. Sun is like the torchlight. Sun is always showing you what are your weaknesses. Scorpio is the sign of inner weakness, internal weaknesses, psychological baggage. This is the sign of Scorpio. Okay. So when Sun sits there, Sun is telling you, look, my dear sir, you have this, you have to work on it. Okay. So Sun is very good in the sign of Scorpio. Of course, any planet in Scorpio will give you challenges. There is no doubt about it. But on a positive side, I am saying Jupiter and Sun does relatively good in Scorpio. Okay, these are perhaps only the two planets which does good in Scorpio, because they give you the power to go above it. Okay, these are the only two planets which will help you to go above your weaknesses and to conquer them, especially Jupiter. Okay, so Sun is good there, and in Pisces also it is good. It goes up to charity and doing donations and ultimately going towards moksha. Spirituality is fabulous there. And in Cancer also it is quite good, not very great in Cancer. The person has a very soft nature, and his major focus is towards his home, the family which he creates after marriage. Okay, so that is okay in Cancer. Not may not be very great, but definitely it is good. It's a very peaceful sign for Sun to be placed in. Okay, and so I've shown you for Sun, and for Moon also, relatively Aries is quite a good sign. Only thing is it makes the person very impulsive. Okay, the mind likes to jump from here to one thing to another because of that impulsive sign of Aries, but still it is very strong and fixed. And in Sagittarius, Moon is very powerful because it is the sign of Jupiter. Every planet is good in Sagittarius because that's a divine sign, right? Divinity is there. Every planet becomes divine. In Pisces, Moon is fabulous. The person does so many charity. Do you know this the famous personality Bill Gates? Who doesn't know him? He has his moon placed in the sign of Pisces. So see, it's a beautiful sign. And then we have Aries is gone, Scorpio is gone, and then Sagittarius is gone, Pisces is gone, and then Leo, Moon in Leo. The person is very bold and very courageous. He's mentally very strong. He's very determined inside. Once he thinks something that I will do this, he will do it. He's like very strong, and he can become a great leader also, just like Sun in Leo. Okay. And then Jupiter also does fabulous in the sign of Scorpio because it can learn a lot of lessons and teach others, because Scorpio is the sign of lessons and reversals and transformations, etc. Okay. And in Sagittarius, it is his own sign, is very powerful. Pisces also, there's no doubt. And in Leo, Jupiter is extremely powerful because Jupiter gets exalted in 5 degrees of Cancer. And if you go to the Navamsha, 5 degrees of Cancer goes into the Navamsha of Leo. So if Jupiter is exalted in Cancer in 5 degrees, in Pushya Nakshatra, first Pada, in Navamsha, which is the chart of destiny and luck and spirituality and your inner progress, about which we'll discuss later, Jupiter goes into Leo there. So which is, it is very powerful there because Leo is the royal sign. Okay, the person can become a great spiritual leader because Jupiter is spirituality and Leo is the royal sign. Okay, so he can become a great preacher of spirituality. He will be like the king of those who give spiritual knowledge. So, and Cancer, it gets exalted because when you practice spirituality with emotions, and then you go to those heights where nobody can reach you because you are so much connected to God, because ultimately everybody is emotional, right? That is why it gets exalted there. And then in Aries also it does very good. Only thing in Aries is the person can be too much concerned about his ideals and too much concerned about what he thinks is right or what he thinks is wrong. And at times these people I have seen, they can get too much angry. Okay, but it does relatively well in the sign of Aries also because it is also the sum of sign of firmness. So these people are very firm with their ideals and they are like, yes, we got to do this, then they will do it. They will never compromise with their ideals. Okay, and they are very idealistic. Only thing is if there are malefic planets aspecting Jupiter or it is with a malefic planet, this can give too much rise to anger or too much fanaticism or too much ego also, especially if Sun is also there with that.